emphasize the two tasks. One, for group behavior, and two, for individual behavior. With this emphasis, it is now time to further relax the restrictions as follows. Number one, we have decided to reopen schools for the candidate classes of P7, S4, S6, finalists in tertiary colleges, and finalists in universities. Why? Number one, we think that it is safe because the finalists in each learning institution are a much smaller number compared to the total enrollment in these centers. Indeed, the total number of finalists is 1.2 million learners out of the total of 15 million, i.e. less than 10%. Therefore, each group of finalists will have bigger space for social distancing, whether they are in the day schools or boarding schools. If they follow the SOPs, they will be safe. Moreover, the cost of waiting any further is quite high. Why? It is because of the jam that will be created in terms of the usual transition from the primary school, the lower secondary schools, the higher secondary schools, the tertiary colleges, and the universities respectively. If the batch of 2020 do not move on, what will happen to the batch of 2021? Can we afford to have the two batches in 2021? The answer is a clear no. Fortunately, it can be done safely if people follow the SOPs. A solution for the non-finalist learners will be found by January 2021. International schools that have got less numbers can engage the Minister of Health on the way forward. The schools will open for the finalists on the 15th of October 2020. We are aware of the dilemma of the private schools that were operating on money from banks, etc. We have tried to help the teachers in the private schools by giving them Uganda shillings 20 billion grant for their SACCO. I had some private school teachers that were complaining that the government was not caring about them. This is a grant, not a loan by the government of 20 billion shillings. It's a grant. This is your bank now. You can use it. We shall continue to study and see how the government can affordably further support these Ugandans, the teachers, in the private schools. The schools will now open in the limited way pointed out above. If for some reasons there are private schools that cannot reopen on account of the obvious disruption of the business of the private schools, because the private schools were doing business, education as a business. They were doing education as a business. Now the business atmosphere is not good because of this disease. So even when we open, if some schools do not open because of the business economics can no longer work out, the Minister of Education is already directed to expand the number of secondary schools. We are assuming a secondary school enrollment of 2 million learners. just for the Chibaro. We assumed 2 million secondary school students, although the actual number is now 1.6 million. If we take one classroom and one teacher to cater for 50 learners, we need 40,000 classrooms and 40,000 classroom teachers. If you assume a school of two streams per class up to S4, and then a science and an arts class for S5 and S6, each school would be having 12 classroom units. This would therefore mean about, to cater for the 2 million students, we'd need about 3,340 secondary schools to accommodate the 2 million secondary school learners. The government already has 1,267 secondary schools, and we are planning, although this number keeps changing, the other day they were talking of another number, but now they are talking of 1,267 secondary schools, government ones. And we are planning to build another 374 new schools. I direct the Minister of Education to study the number of community schools that the government can take over in the areas that do not have government secondary schools. If the worst comes to the worst, the government should have the capacity to absorb into government schools all the learners and even the teachers that are shed off by the private schools on account of the financial difficulties facing private schools precipitated by the COVID-19 crisis. The Minister of Finance should also meet the owners of the private schools and see how the government could come to their aid. The government should not only think of rescuing the learners and the teachers and remain oblivious of the plight of those Ugandan entrepreneurs that invested in private schools because they did not know that a terrible disease would come from the bats in distant China and cause so much chaos. Can UDB help? What is the magnitude of the money involved? The government plan for distance learning through the provision of the 9 million radio sets is on course. The money is available and those radios will be provided. That route of alternative learning will continue to be consolidated, not only for dealing with the present crisis, but also for the future. I would want Ugandans to really understand this, the importance of this distance learning. In other parts of the world, learning is continuing. The children don't have to take the risk of going to gather. They learn through the internet. Children are sitting here in Kampala, they are doing exams given in the US. I had one of my children who was at the University of Bath. He had not finished some of his last papers. He ran here and he did his papers here and he finished. He's here with us. So this route of distance learning is a very good route, and we are going to consolidate it. Now some people are saying, Museveni, you are wasting money. When you buy the radios, the fathers will take them from the children and use them to listen to disco. That one we shall struggle with. We have struggled with many problems. Mm-hmm. that strategy of distance learning may have some advantages, such as democratizing access by all to good teachers. If there is a good teacher, you normally hear, oh, there is a good teacher for science,